I am happy to say I am here today not to accept a medal, but to announce one. I am delighted to present to you the Stephen Hawking Medal for Science Communication.
Our sun is just a speck in the vast beach of stars.
I suppose you could say that what defines me is that I'm an explainer. After all, what's the use of learning something new about the world if you don't then tell everyone about it?
So, although gravity appears to be a force, it's nothing more than the curvature of space itself. When an object falls, it's not being pulled by gravity at all. It's just following the simplest path through bent space.
Each time he set light to the gas, a dewy liquid began to appear on the surface of the glass.
I've made hard-hitting documentaries. I've taken the odd risk. I've even been allowed to do some hard sums. I've never wanted to be a science communicator. I wanted to be a scientist who communicates. When I think back to my scientific heroes, there are very few who've managed to succeed as both researchers and communicators. Until recent years, you were expected to choose. I feel lucky to be of the generation that can be accepted as both. In fact, I'd go as far as to say that science has really entered popular culture.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the University of Surrey. I'm moving up the pecking order to Sir David Attenborough. Next in line, I'll be interviewing God.
That's the worst thing that's happened to me as an adult.
I sometimes wonder whether those of us scientists in the public eye do what we do because we like being in the spotlight, that we enjoy showing off. But actually, it's not that at all. Yes, I guess if we didn't like the attention, we wouldn't do it. But actually, the pleasure we derive is from sharing our fascination, our excitement, our sheer joy in the discovery that we can, to a greater or lesser extent, comprehend the universe. I probably enjoy radio as a medium even more than television. I have a timer here. The rules of quantum mechanics. Your time starts now.
Okay. Could you encapsulate that explanation in, say, 30 seconds?
No.
It's sort of hard to express what an astonishing achievement this is, that from our small planet orbiting an unremarkable star, we've reached out into the universe and seen as far as it's possible to see with light. Boom. Science.